Bhakti, Kokisho Swami Ji Maharaj, Ki Jai, Jai Mishabhad, Paramahansa Prabhu Gaurachara, Shishya Bhakti, Sanjay Nanda, Shala Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Ki Jai, Parshan Prasad, Bhama Sri Jagannath, Das Prabhu Ji Maharaj, Ki Jai, Rupa Nandi Gauri Guru Bhaga, Ki Jai, Ananda Koti Vaishnavind, Ki Jai, Gaur Premanandi,
Kalpatarubhyascha Kripasindhubhyascha Patitanam Pavanibhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradaya Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namne Gaura Krishna
Sila Garudet sangat berbahagia sekali datang kembali ke rumah Nanda Krishna. Jadi banyak sekali yang mengingatkan beliau atas kunjungan-kunjungan beliau.
When I entered this place, I remember the villages of Bengal and Odisha.
Jadi begitu beliau sampai di Bali, mengingatkan beliau dengan suatu daerah di Bengali.
Because Bengal is the birthplace of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Sebab Bengali adalah tempat di mana Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu melaksanakan diri.
And Orissa, like Puri, in the place of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Jagannath and his all associates.
Dan Orissa adalah merupakan tempat Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu dan Sri Jagannath dengan semua pengikut beliau.
Same rainy day in India, in Orissa and Bengal. Same type of cows, very beautiful. like the cows of Orisha and Bengal. Or this lotus frog, I never seen anywhere in my tomb. It remembered me three places, especially of Vrindavan, where it has been told. So many lotus flowers everywhere. Also in Puri, in so many ponds, they can see lotus flowers. A thousand and thousand of these are always humming. And then beautiful to see. Oh, I see here, saw here, so many beautiful flowers, especially champak, on which the name of champak bulb. Champak Gaon in Navadvip. Champahati of Champak Lata. Also devotees like Bengal, very simple, very simple.
Yeah. Jadi, Gurudev menyatakan, jadi musim hujan yang beliau ketemukan di Bali, itu merupakan kesamaan juga dengan terjadinya di Bengali dan Orissa. Dan di sini juga beliau menemukan sapi-sapi yang mana itu ada kesamaannya dengan di Bengali dan Orissa. Dan di sini beliau terkesan dengan bunga padma yang berada di tangan beliau sekarang, yaitu bunga yang jarang sekali beliau temukan di dalam kunjungan beliau di dunia-dunia luar. Tetapi itu dapat kita temukan juga di Bengali dan Orissa, yaitu di Urturi.
Also I remember here, Mahabharata, Bhim, Hindumbak, the very beautiful chariots, very artist. I remember when Bhim was fighting with snakes. Also, so beautiful chariot, like Krishna is sitting on the chariot and he is giving some teachings to Arjuna. I think that this land is named after Bali. Who Bali? The brother of Sukriya. And he was so much strong. Perhaps he used to come here to worship Sun, and he was so strong that Ram was defeated by him. So Bali is a place of that Bali, I think. And I think that there are so many similarities, like Puris, Orisha. Arts like same as Orisha. Very beautiful arts. I went to Malaysia and saw a Garud, beautiful, caught in wood. I appreciated. I told the householder that from where they have collected this Garud. I collected it from Bali. Oh. Then I will go and tell Ananta Prabhu and Radhakanta Prabhu how beautiful they are. If it is found, I will see and take it to India. Very beautiful. So it remembers all the Ramayana and Mahabharata past times. Also it remembers me, Dasavatar from Matsya, Kurma, Varaha, Nisinga, Parshuram, Vaman, Ram. Then Balaram, Buddha Kalki, all in their hearts. If we can appreciate a little Bhakti, I think very much preaching can be done here. The hearts of here persons, maybe if it is maybe helped little, they will incline towards Bhakti. So I think that you should all inspire them to come towards Bhakti and their lives should be successful.
Jadi begitu Guru Dev sampai di Bali, jadi beliau diingatkan dengan kejadian-kejadian tentang Mahabharata, di mana dalam perjalanan dari airport ke tempat ini, beliau menemukan yaitu Gatot Kaca sedang berada di atas kereta dengan ditarik oleh kuda, Bima dengan ular di tangannya. Dan di situ juga dijelaskan Bali merupakan suatu tempat yang mana pernah disinggah oleh Maharaja Bali yang pernah berperang dengan Sri Rama. Dan juga di situ beliau mengingatkan kita tentang 10 jenis avatara yaitu Matsya, Kurma, Narasinga, Rasuram dan Buddha. Buddha sosok?
Ya, ya.
Kalki.
I remember by arts here.
Beliau diingatkan dengan melihat ukiran-ukiran yang terpampang di Bali. Dan juga beliau pada waktu berada di Malaysia, beliau melihat satu patung Garuda di rumah. Di situ beliau diterima di rumah seorang penyembah. Jadi di situ beliau melihat patung Garuda dan beliau menanyakan kepada pemilik rumah itu di mana sebenarnya patung Garuda itu didapatkan. Dan pemilik rumah itu mengatakan bahwa patung Garuda itu dikirim dari Bali. Di situ juga beliau menyatakan mungkin perguruan Rekanta atau saya bisa mempersembahkan satu patung Garuda kepada Garuda.
I also remember here where our reverend and honorable Om Vishnu Parashishma Guru Gobind Maharaj used to come here and used to stay here. There is a room for him. So it remembers me that he used to come and preach here. And you are so lucky and fortunate to serve him and to hear his speeches. Very bold, too bold to speak true. And that is why in a very few days he will become so popular that all began to high class of leaders began to fear that all disciples will go to him and take shelter. And that is why they wanted to ban on him. He thought that it is better to go from here to be banned. He was not a person to be banned. He was in the same line of Rupa Goswami, Swamiji, in which I'm also trying to be bold like him, to preach in his line, that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu trained for teaching Raganuga, Rag, Varg, Marga, Anuvarga, to preach Raganuga, Marga, not only Bhakti Marga. Though Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur and our Guru Varga, they preached Bhakti Vinod Thakur. But that preaching was not by the Bhakti. it is seen like Vaidhi Bhakti. But anyone following that Vaidhi Bhakti of Jaiva Dharma, of Chaitanya Charitamrita, and hearing the words of Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, if anyone hearing very patiently and deeply, they will turn to Bhagavan. Certainly, a greed will come to serve Radha Krishna Kanyuga. If that greed is not coming, then their life is bogus. They should go to Ramanuj, Sri Sampradaya, and other Sampradayas. This is the speciality of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That he has not come to give only Bhajji Bhakti. He came to be and to see seed, a seed in the heart of devotees of what? Krishna Seva Vasana. The desire to serve Radha and Krishna can be worked. This was the main object of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Rupusha and others.
So,
Rupusha
Maharaj
is
beginning at that, Sukhdi Bhaya Vedishi meeting at Kunjumandari Sira Gaurudana Maharaj. Yang mana beliau hadir di tempat ini pula mengajarkan tentang hari kata secara tegas sekali beliau di situ menjelaskan tentang Krishna. Tetapi karena beliau adalah seorang hari guru, jadi pada hari-hari guru yang lainnya merasa takut kepada beliau. Apa ketakutan yang di alam beliau? Karena beliau takut akan murid-muridnya diambil oleh sila guru Maharaj. Oleh karena itu, jadi para hari-hari guru tersebut berusaha untuk melarang murid-muridnya untuk bergaul dengan sila guru Maharaj, karena takut semua murid-muridnya itu akan meninggalkannya. Oleh karena itu, sila guru Maharaj merasa lebih baik pergi dari tempat ini daripada mengalami larangan-larangan tersebut. Jadi beliau sudah menunjukkan suatu jalan kebenaran yang sangat berafiat sekali, dan juga di sini dijelaskan beliau adalah merupakan garis keturunan dari Sri Rupa Goswami. Dari Sri Rupa Goswami, yang mana guru-guru yang sangat berafiat sekali, dan juga beliau adalah merupakan garis keturunan dari Sri Sila Bhakti. Dan juga beliau adalah merupakan garis keturunan dari Sila Bhakti Sada Saraswati Thakur. Dan juga Sri Ramanujacharya, yang mana beliau mengamalkan apa yang disebut dengan Vaidhi Bhakti. Vaidhi Bhakti. Jadi kalau kita melaksanakan Vaidhi Bhakti dengan ketat sekali, dengan sesuai aturan-aturan yang telah dituangkan di dalam kitab suci Weda, maka kita akan menuju kepada yang disebut dengan Praganuga Bhakti.
We have not come to make any problem or any devotee. We have not come to collect money. We have not come here to make disciples and to take anyone's disciple. We have come here only for needy person to help them in Krishna consciousness without any self-gain. We want to help all. Like Nityananda Prabhu and Haridas Thakur, even beaten, even abused, no how, because we have not come for any rivalry or anything. Like Gopal Govind Maharaj, came here to preach the mission of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So simply we have come to preach and to touch the hearts of devotees and to help if they need. I know that they need, surely they need. Because after Swamiji and after Gaura Govinda Maharaj, the field of paddy field was began to draw. Though so much water, rainfall is coming, but not touching that field. What water can touch? If it will come from the installation of deposit, pure devotees of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Without any gain, only they are coming to give that object what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Purusham gave. So they need water. And what is that water? Harikatha. So we want to get some Harikatha to the devotee. Then again they should be inspired so that the Kripa of Bhakti should go up and think that very soon so many sweet fruits will be there and they should taste it. Our purpose or object to come here.
Jadi di sini, Srila Gurudev dengan tegas menyatakan, beliau datang kembali bukan untuk mencari pengikut, bukan untuk collecting money, bukan untuk bertengkar. Jadi beliau datang di sini untuk mengajarkan Hari Guru. Jadi mengajarkan tentang ajaran Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Seperti halnya juga, Srila Gauranga Maharaj datang kembali hanya untuk mengajarkan itu, bukan untuk propaganda, bukan untuk mencari kekayaan. Jadi beliau datang ke Bali, datang seluruhnya adalah untuk mengajarkan misi daripada Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Selain itu tidak ada. Seperti halnya yang dialami oleh Sri Haridas Thakur. Seperti yang dialami oleh Sri Vidyananda Prabhu dan Haridas Thakur, yang mana beliau dipukul, dihina dan dicaci, tetapi tetap beliau berusaha untuk meyakinkan orang untuk mengikuti ajaran daripada Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Jadi beliau datang kembali tidak ada motivasi lain, tidak ada motivasi secara pribadi, dan beliau hanya datang untuk mengajarkan hari kata yang mana seperti aliran air hujan yang mengalir tanpa terkontaminasikan dari pencemaran-pencemaran lain, dan mana air itu adalah asli aliran dari air yang dialir oleh Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Jadi setelah kepergian daripada Srila Prabhupada dan Sri Gauranga Maharaj, jadi di situ filsafat daripada ajaran Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sudah mengalami suatu kemerosotan yang mana itu dirasakan sangat kering sekali, sehingga di sini Srila Gurudev mendapat perintah untuk mengajarkan kembali ajaran Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu secara murni.
I know that all wants to be happy in life, but the process they adopt, that process cannot be eternal bliss and happiness. Only the process that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu shows, explains, to chant and remember holy name of Krishna. Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead. And if he chants his name, more powerful than what Krishna is, so much more. So Krishna will inspire everything in that day. And this process don't needs money, cost, wealth, reputation, fair complex, or complex, so much intelligence, nothing. So we can adopt this. Only chanting Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
We will try to explain all these things. Perhaps we will be here 7 days, or about 7 days. So, we will explain the object of human beings and what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has taught for us. Very easy thing. We will try to explain. And also, with us, there are so many learned and experienced Vaishnava devotees. They will also explain all these things. Today I will have to take rest. So, one question should be done after that. I will go to rest. And if found today, this will make some casuals and program that how we should go on with our programs. Sometimes we may go to Anant Gaudiya Math. I want to see Anant Gaudiya
Math.
I have heard and have written very beautiful. But it is not completed. But even we will go one day.
Certainly part of the death of energy.
How much percent?
75% finished.
Oh,
right. Jadi, di sini Srila Gurudev menyatakan, setiap orang itu berhak untuk hidup berbahagia. Tetapi di sini proses yang diajarkan oleh Sri Chaitanya Prabhu adalah sangat spesial. Jadi proses yang diajarkan oleh Sri Chaitanya Prabhu yaitu hanya satu, yaitu mengucapkan mahamantra itu sendiri. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Jadi di sini tidak usah takut, tidak usah berpolitik, tidak usah menginginkan hal-hal yang negatif itu. Jadi sila Guru datang ke Bali hanya untuk itu. Jadi beliau akan di sini di Bali selama kurang lebih 6 hari, yaitu mulai tanggal 17 sampai dengan tanggal 22. Jadi di sini beliau menyarankan agar kita membuat suatu program yang sangat baik sekali, dan kepada para penyembah yang tergabung di dalam murid-murid dari Sri Gurudev, kami mohon untuk menyiapkan waktunya sebanyak mungkin, yaitu pada siang pagi hari dan malam hari. Karena pada pagi hari kita akan bisa dasan secara pribadi kepada Gurudev, menyampaikan hal-hal kita yang sangat pribadi, permasalahan-permasalahan kita. Dan pada sore hari beliau akan mengajarkan tentang lila daripada Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare
Krishna. You should make a program how we can give classes and time and everything.
I have to invite somebody from outside of our Samadaya, especially local spiritual members, and I invite all of them to come starting tomorrow at day 21. We will start our program 17.
Today 17.
5 o'clock.
What time? 5 o'clock in the afternoon. He invited many spiritual leaders, local, to come every day.
But in the morning maybe it's only our good brother.
Our devotees in the morning.
But the local...
in the afternoon, the local devotees.
In the afternoon, around 5 o'clock, till your granting schedule. Because I inform of all of them, your lecture will be held within 5:30 until 7 o'clock.
Yes. Can
we make
the announcement?
Done
in the morning, we can
do Mangalati. Mangalati should be done.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mangalati
our devotees will be here for Mangalati.
So, can we ask program for
Mangalati? Our all programs should be done here. Because there are so many devotees here coming from us, with us.
Tadi disinisila Garudev untuk sikan kepada kita semua, agar kita membuat program yang baik sekali, yaitu dari Manggala Rati.
When you do?
5:30.
Yeah.
Manggala Rati kita akan mulai jam 5:30 dan kita akan lanjutkan dengan menyambut arca.
And then kirtan.
Dan setelah itu kita melakukan bhajan dan kirtan.
And after that some classes. And then
class. Dan setelah itu Sila Gurudev akan memberikan kelas juga pagi hari. Sila Gurudev akan
then Prashad. Then 10 o'clock Gurudev will speak.
Nah, setelah kita melakukan bhajan, jadi kita prasad dan jam 10 setelah prasad Sila Gurudev akan memberikan pelajaran pada kita. Hare Krishna. Gaurava Premanandi Hari Sila Gurudev ki jai. Sila Gurudev ki jai. Sila Gurudev ki jai. Premanandi Hari
Ananta Ananta
Krishna
Krishna Gauriya Math ki jai. Ananta Prabhu ki
jai. Jaya Radha Ramana Hari Jai Jai Radha Ramana Hari
Tasya gajah murid.